Hello and welcome to a new colouring video. Today I'm going to be colouring this rabbit and I'm going to do it with watercolours. So it's from this book, Alice in Wonderland by Fabiana Attanasio. So I did start it in the book and I made a bit of a mess of it. Yes, I just wanted to explain what I've done because I laid down the art basics gesso on this page first of all, and it turned out it didn't actually work very well when painting large areas with watercolour paint. So I'm just going to zoom in and show you how the paint ended up. So I'm talking about the background paint. That is not what I wanted to look like, and it's a bit of a mess. I found it almost impossible to do a large area with the watercolour paint on that gesso. Small areas, absolutely fine. If anybody's seen my previous video when I was testing that gesso out, it worked absolutely fine, worked great with coloured pencils, and it worked great with the Inktense watercolour pencils and watercolour paint, just your ordinary watercolour paint, but it just hasn't worked with the larger area. So I just wanted to let everybody know about that. I know a lot of people have said that they've gone out and bought that gesso, and if anybody wanted to like do watercolour paintings on it, I feel a little bit guilty now because I've recommended it. I mean, it is brilliant, but like I said, not for a larger area. So I've traced, and I feel really bad as well because this book was a gift of somebody as well. So I didn't buy it myself, and then I've messed the painting up. So I traced it onto a piece of tracing paper just by hand. I know you can scan the image, but because I'd already coloured some of the picture in, it would have been a bit difficult because I would have then had to remove all the colour in a photo editing programme, and it would have just been a little bit tricky. So I just got an ordinary piece of tracing paper and traced my lines out. And then I'm putting it on some proper watercolour paper. And then I used my tracing light board. If anybody hasn't seen one of these before, it's called like a tracing board or a light board. And I'll just switch the light off so you can see. So the light shines through like that, and then you put your paper over the top. And then you can just easily trace that because the light shines right through the paper. Okay, so I'm going to start again, and I'm going to do this in watercolour paints, and I might finish it off with some pencils, and I think, I won't let this go to waste. I'll finish this off with pencils as well. I'll just go over the top of that with pencils. Okay, so I'm going to start on this now, and it's not going to be a speed video, but it's not going to be a tutorial either. It's not going to be a massively long video. I'm just going to pick certain parts out of it, and I'll speed it up just slightly, just very, very slightly, just to take the boredom away from the video, because if it's too slow, it can get really, really boring if it's absolute real time. So I'll just speed it up a tiny little bit, but you'll still be able to see exactly what I'm doing. I won't have it too fast. Thank you.
Thank you.